going to show you this clean tea that I bought from the first video that you saw. So basically I bought Mother's Love. That's the main one that we're going to be talking about today. So Mr. George, who is down in the rocker because he won't go to sleep, even though I just fed him and he fell asleep and I swaddled him and I put him down, and now he's like, no, I don't care about you, Mum. I'm gonna stay the fuck wide awake. Anyways, back to tea. My mother recommended this to me. She tagged me in a Facebook post. And I wanted to give it a try. So I read, before my laptop decided to shit itself, that it is good for Mum and Bub's digestive system. It will help with his burping and his poo, well, his farts, because it's pretty gassy in both ends. You can hear him talking to himself, Mr. Cutie. So I have the tea here. So I bought this tin. You select what stick you'd like on the front of it. So I obviously pick Mother's Love because I got the big pack of 100 grams, and then this small pack came in the breastfeeding safe tea box. I'm not going to worry about those teas for a while because a lot of them are like sleeping, and I really don't want to affect him from drinking 30,000 different teas. And also you get a free 50 gram pack of detox tea, which I need to look up because I wouldn't mind drinking some of that. But yeah, so in this tea there comes this. I wish it came with like telling me what it does for my body on a booklet, but it doesn't. Anyway, so the Mother's Love breastfeeding tea is for colic, so for his colon and all of that. But Mum said it will help with his burps because it worked with my brother's burps. It has nettle, caraway, fennel, aniseed, and vervain. So, I had some of this last night, and George was been fighting like a trooper, and I can hear the shit come out. But, he's been good. He hasn't been waking up screaming like he was the other two nights. This smells like black licorice, so I'm just putting it in a container. I thought you people would be interested in me, you know, putting shit in containers. So let me move over there. So, you know, feel entertained by watching me do this? If not, you can go ahead and skip it because you can do that on YouTube now. Gosh, it's like such a strong licorice smell. I'm totally in for it. All right. Done, done, done. Okay, so now we've come over to my little tea making section, whatever it's called. And basically on the back of this card that they give you, it just tells you what to do, which is pretty self-explanatory. So add 1 teaspoon per cup to the infuser or teapot, add boiling water, allow to infuse for 3 to 4 minutes. So I like drinking my teas cold, if I'm honest, but so I got these little teaspoons. They're like old vintage teaspoons. I got them for like $1 from the op shop instead of spending $14 at T2 for a freaking teaspoon. So I just say 1.5 of these is the right amount. And then yeah, I just leave them in the container. Oh, wrong lid. And my diffuser is from T2. It's just a cute, very cute one. And I've already boiled my water. Oh, you can't even see me, even though it's not that safe, me pouring. There we go. And let me show you a close up of it. So here's the lovely tea in there, and I just cap this over in 4 minutes. Okay, we are back, and it has diffused for a while. I actually forgot about it, if I'm honest. And I left it in there for a long while. So just bring all the tea, because I don't want it to dry in here, otherwise it won't filter properly. And then here is the tea. So I believe Google said to drink it four times. Not Google, the website said drink it four times a day. I'm just gonna do it with breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And maybe if I feel like it, I'll put some in the fridge and I'll make it at midnight. I'll drink some at midnight. But yeah, I'm gonna put some ice in this. I actually don't own any big cups, but I'm going to have a squeeze. I might just use this Coca-Cola cup. Funny story, at the end of my pregnancy, I actually have really nice matching cups, white cups. But at the end of my pregnancy, I was losing my marbles. And one of our family members accidentally broke my cup. And I was like, didn't care at the time. And then I counted all my cups and they were an odd number. And I started crying. And I was getting overwhelmed over the dumbest shit by the end of the pregnancy. So I only have Coke cups now, so no one touches my pretty cups because they're all hand blown and handmade, and you know, now they're not. There's an ant on my phone. So yeah, just pour it in. You didn't even see what I did, you're just looking at my titties right now. So I probably put that back up because that's not that nice. So there we go, there's my tea. There's still a bit left in here. Fucking moron. So I'll just drink the whole cup and then come back. Hey, so day two of drinking this Mother's Love tea. Three times a day. I've been forgetting to have it in the middle of the night. Last night George was awake from 12 till 3 a.m. So I put him in this new rocker that I got and fell asleep, but I was just exhausted from that. I have noticed a difference in his bowel movements. He's not upset before he farts, I guess. He usually is having a little bit of a fuss before he does move bowels, but he's just been happy and has just been letting out little farts at a time instead of a massive explosive fart, because yeah, they're wild, those farts, and I'm happy he's happy and he's just asleep right now on the couch. Trying to get him in the routine of understanding swaddle means bedtime. But yeah, so I'll get back to you after I've been trying this for a week, but I'd like to vlog this for at least a month to give you the full, if it really works. And yeah, thank you, see you in a couple of days. Well, see you in a couple of minutes, really, or seconds, how I edit it. Hey, week three of me drinking the mummy's drink. It has helped a bit, I must admit. Rhymes. I can't move too far back because I'm in maternity bra. So I have been drinking it three times a day. I have been slack sometimes. If we've had a full day out, I haven't had it. I've noticed a bit more of an effect. George's farts and that, they're not all in one clump. He's letting them out little bits at a time. That's kind of like what infant's friend does. So it is making a bit of a difference, but I think I might just stick to infant's friends and just continue taking that, or giving it to him when I feed him every feed, because that just is more effective. It's straight into him, it's not in my milk. So I'm going to stop it and see a difference and just use infant's friend for now. And then I'll give you the final answer soon. Okay, so I've been drinking the Mother's Love tea now for a month and a bit and it's done nothing. I'm not going to buy it ever again. I suggest you guys don't even waste your money on it. For something that does help with colic problems for bub, I suggest using infant's friend, which I have also been using this whole time with every single feed, and it works. Don't bother wasting your money on Mother's Love. I'll still drink it because it tastes like black licorice and I love black licorice, but that's really it. Thank you for your time watching this video. If you'd like me to review anything else, just comment down below. And if it's really expensive, I probably won't, but if it's affordable, I will. I'm really shit at concluding. I'll practice soon. But yes, so if you did like the video, like it, subscribe, comment down below, you know, whatever the super cool YouTubers say. But yeah, see you next time.